And for more on the spread of Ebola, we're joined by David Quammen, author of Ebola, The Natural and Human History of a Deadly Virus. Thank you so much for joining us from Irvine.
Glad to be with you.
How do you think the hospital in Dallas handled Ebola? Should anyone or any agency, at that matter, be at fault for these two U.S. nurses becoming infected? What do you make of all the finger-pointing we've been seeing and hearing the last few days?
Well, I think finger-pointing is to some degree called for because mistakes were made, and it needs to be understood why those mistakes were made and how they can be corrected. Things did not go well at Presbyterian Hospital in Dallas, and I believe it's reassuring now that those two patients have been moved to Atlanta and to Bethesda to be cared for in containment suites where there has been more training and there is more expertise in how to deal with these cases.
So do you think every Ebola patient should be going to the same location in the United States?
Not necessarily. There are, I believe, four hospitals that are particularly equipped for this. One in Bethesda, one in Atlanta, one, I believe, in Omaha, and one in Missoula, Montana, if I understand that correctly. Not far from the Rocky Mountain Laboratories, where a lot of work on BSL-4, these most dangerous kinds of viruses, have been done. Now, those facilities have people who have been thoroughly trained to deal with this kind of case. The training that was offered in Dallas seems to have been superficial at best, and we really need to step up. We need for the CDC to step up and make sure that there is more thorough training, that these protocols are more rigorous and rigorously observed. I think that can be done and certainly will be done in Bethesda and at Emory.
And David, it's not just the United States. You know, we have the case in Spain where a nurse also became infected treating a couple of patients. In general, are you surprised by how Ebola has been handled outside of Africa? Does it seem that no hospital is ready, regardless of where it's located?
I would say that that's not true. We know that that the disease spread to Lagos, Nigeria, and that was at first a nightmare scenario, a city of 21 million people, and yet it was stopped. I believe there were 20 cases and only eight fatalities in Nigeria. I believe that that was because there was good, strong healthcare expertise and infrastructure from the Nigerians, and because they had help not only from the CDC, but also from the Bill and Melinda Gates Foundation and some other organizations. So if it can be done in Lagos and in Nigeria, if it can be done in the United Kingdom, in London, it should be able to be done in other Western and developed countries.
You've said in the past that this is part of a pattern before, and this Ebola outbreak is not a one-off situation. So how can we be better prepared to handle the next epidemic globally?
Well, we need more expenditure. I know that's not a popular thing to say, but we need more expenditure on health preparedness. In the U.S., that means probably reversing the budget cuts that the CDC has suffered. The Department of Homeland Security has some activity in this area, and there should be more support for that. The World Health Organization has also had its budget cut, and that should be reversed. We have great expertise. We have great science that's being done on this in terms of designing new forms of speedy diagnostics, that sort of work. The work of people like Dr. Ian Lipkin at the Mailman School of Public Health in Columbia University needs to be supported. And we need more training. We need more preparation, not just for treating Ebola patients, but for treating the next virus that comes down the road next year and the one after that. These viruses are going to continue to emerge, and they're going to continue to travel by airplane in human beings. We need to be ready for the next one.
All right, certainly a wake-up call there. David Quammen, author of Ebola, The Natural and Human History of a Deadly Virus. Thank you so much for joining us.